Thank you. To interpret all these papers which with which Des has so kindly furnished me. That is all at this stage.
Thank you. precursors of this band was a band which has appeared here called Moten Swing, a 10-piece band based originally on the Benny Moten band. And arrangement we didn't do then, but we could have, from, because it was a Benny Moten tune, we are going to do now. It's called Jones Law Blues. I don't know what Jones Law was. If anyone does, I'd be very interested to hear. Perhaps I should put it in Bernie's Guide or something like that. But I'd like to know if anyone does know. Jones Law Blues.
Doomsday Book.
Thank you.
there is any rollo, why should it be minor? With their Dixie eyes blazing, how I love to sit gazing to the eyes of Diverly. Set up every night, why do I shake the fire? Because my dynamite changed the mind about me.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. That was a tune called D Natural Blues, recorded by the 12-piece Fletcher Henderson Orchestra, and as there are less than 12 pieces of us, we blew for that very noisily to make up for the shortage. We're going to call Norman Field to join us on stand, and he's going to play When I'm Blue with us. He's going to play lead alto on that. And it's a, When I'm Blue, it's a tune recorded by the Halfway House Orchestra, which amazingly comes from an establishment called the Halfway House, and even more amazingly, it was so called because it lay halfway between New Orleans Central and Lake Pontchartrain. Anyway, this is a tune called, what did I say, it was called When I'm Blue, When I'm Blue.
Des did ask me to say things earlier on, but I told you at the time I had the great honour of playing with this band that occupied all my residual brain power just to try and look at the many sheets of paper which Des has industriously prepared, not only for the band but also for me, a sort of transient guest is not immune from many sheets of paper which I am actually putting all my attention into. The reason I didn't play on the last one is because Des asked me whether I'd like to play on it or not. And I can tell you that the key of D natural is most unfriendly for jazz bands, the key of piano D, which has two sharps, which I think is several sharps on a clarinet. So there we are. Oh, right, sorry. Here we go. Suddenly it's halfway between New Orleans and somewhere else.
Thank you. queer playing when you're smiling. What? No, you're going to sing it. Excuse me, I wasn't talking to the audience then. I was talking to Malcolm Hurrell, telling them... Indeed.
You need to go talking to.
Telling him that he's going to sing it. Sorry about that. It was all right until then, wasn't it? Yeah. Anyway, he's going to sing a tune entitled When You're Smiling. That's after I put the microphone up there. Just arrange the next number, and it's a tune which was recorded by Jimmy Noon a long time ago. It was written in 1926, so that gives you an idea. It's ages ago, older than me, just. And it's called I Know That You Know.
Mm-hmm.
asked Pen Pengelly to join us on metal, E flat, clarinet, and he's going to play a spiritual, just to change the mood completely. The spiritual is entitled Lead Me Saviour, in the key of B flat if you want to sing along. Two flats, B flat and E flat.
Thank you.
playing the tune, it'll be called Ma is Making Eyes at Me.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Williams, and it's called Black Snake Blues.
Thank you.
Tune, probably his most famous tune, it's called South. Thank you. Tune which was recorded by Vic Spiderbeck and Frankie Trumbauer. Frankie Trumbauer, and it's called Singing the Blues. And Norman's going to do the Trumbauer bit, and Steve's going to do the Vic's bit. I don't know who was on piano, but I'm going to do a piano bit. Arthur's going to do the Dorsey bit, Jim Dorsey bit, aren't you? That's that bit there. Right. Anyway, Singing the Blues. To do another feature, and it's a tune called Didn't I Tell You That You'd Come Back? back, I hope. Yes, I see him coming.
I'm coming back.
The Dennis Armstrong buck, here they are.
Good name for a tune.
All I do is take me trip. What kind of person is take my call?
Gentlemen, my excuse for returning so tardily to the stand is a very simple but I hope significant one, that I was actually talking out there to John Minion, the organiser of the festival, or as he is known amongst us musicians, El Supremo, and doing liaison, so please forgive me.
A tune recorded by Clarence Williams, and it's called Close Fit Blues.
One, two, three, four.
Asked me to tell you about the song Tiptoe Through the Tulips. There's very little I can tell you about this, except that it was from a very popular film of about 1929 or 30, and it had this song in it, and perhaps Broadway Melody. I think it was Broadway Melody and Tiptoe Through the Tulips. They used to be coupled on the same, on the other sides of the record. So we're going to play Tiptoe Through the Tulips right now.
Thank you.
thanks to Dennis Armstrong. In order to make a sensible programme, we're supposed to finish at 8:30, but we're running on a bit, and it's up to you whether you stay or not. If you've got some other commitments, I should point it out, but it is a thing. But in order to, you know, I like to play a slow tune and a fast tune alternately, and I like to change the key, and I like to change the mood, because otherwise everyone goes to sleep, keep on doing the same old thing. So we're going to do something different now. What are we going to do? Oh, yes, this is a Duke Ellington tune called Misty Morning. On the cusp of the 20s, as it were, it's called Happy Feet. But before I do that, I should tell everyone, especially for tax purposes, who's in the band. On trumpet, Steve Grahan. Yeah! On the reeds is Arthur Vincent. Yeah! On the drums, who's on the drums? It's Roger Wells. On the sousaphone is Richard Willey. And on the banjo and a singing bit is Mount Hurrell. Special guests we've had amongst us have included Pen Pengelly. Dennis Armstrong. And our star for this afternoon, Norman Field. My name is Des Bacon.
One, two, three, four.